topic that we're going to see today is percentages. Percentages is one of the most important topics for any competitive exam, be it CAT, SNAP, ZAT, IAFT, MAT, TANSET, or any other exam when it comes to, you know, government related exams like bank, RRB, SSC. So percentage is the base topic. So once we are confident about percentages, we can look at profit and loss, simple and compound interest, as well as there are other topics like data interpretation where, you know, we have to use the formulas related to percentages. First, we look at some of the basic concepts when it comes to percentages. The first basic concept. So when I talk about 10%, what is 10%? 10% is nothing but 10 by 100. In terms of fractions, it is 1 by 10. Similarly, what is 50%? 50% is 50 by 100. 50 by 100 is again nothing but 1 by 2. So just in case if I say that I have 100 apples and another person, Raju, is coming to me and telling me that he has 50% of the number of apples that I have. So if I am having 100 apples and Raju is having 50% of the number of apples that I have, he is nothing but he is having half of what I have. So what is half of 100? So what is half of 100? It will be nothing but 50. So he has half of what I have, so he will be having 50 apples. So 50% in terms of fractions is nothing but 1 by 2. So if you look at it carefully, 100%, 100% is nothing but 100 by 100. What is 100 by 100? 1. 50%, 50% is nothing but, we just know, so right, 50% is nothing but 1 by 2. Similarly, 33.33%, 33.33% is 1 by 3. Now what will be 1 by 4? What will be 1 by 4? So if you look at this carefully, 50% is 1 by 2. 50% is 1 by 2 means, if you need to find out 1 by 4, it is nothing but half of half. So when I take 50% to be 1 by 2, and if I want to get 1 by 4, I just need to divide this by 2. So what is half of 50? It is nothing but 25%. It is nothing but 25%. Similarly, 1 by 5. 1 by 5 is 20%. Because what is 20 by 100? What is 20 by 100? 1 by 5. So this is the base thing. 100% is 1. 50% is 1 by 2. 33.33% is 1 by 3. 25% is 1 by 4. 20% is 1 by 5. Apart from this, we'll go to the next thing. What can be 1 by 6? What can be 1 by 6? If you look at this carefully, 33.33% is 1 by 3. So to get 1 by 6, I need to just divide this by 2. So if I divide 1 by 3, again, if I divide it by 2, I'll get 1 by 6. If I divide one side by 2, I should divide the other side by 2. So 33.33 by 2 is nothing but 16.67%. 1 by 7. How do you remember 1 by 7? How do you remember 1 by 7? The easiest way of remembering this is 7 into 2 is 14. And 14 into 2 is 28. So this is nothing but 14.28%. So 1 by 7 is 7 into 2 is 14. 14 into 2 is 28%. So 1 by 7 is 14.28%. What about 1 by 8? Same thing. Look at the connection between these two. 1 by 4 is 25%. So if I have to get 1 by 8, I need to again divide this by 2. So if I again divide this by 2, I have to divide the right side by 2 means I have to divide the left side by 2. So 25 by 2 is 12.5%. 12.5%. Next will be 1 by 9. 1 by 9, if you look at 1 by 9, the connection is between 1 by 3. Now how do you connect this? In this case, instead of dividing by 2, I should divide by 3. So if I divide 1 by 3, the other side by 3, I will get 1 by 9. So if you divide 33.33 by 3, you will get 11.11%. 1 by 10 we already saw. What is 1 by 10? 10%. 1 by 10 is 10%. So these are the base values which you should remember when it comes to percentages. We look at a few questions as to why this is really, really important, as to how we can apply these fractions when it comes to solving percentage questions. So if you have a question, what is 33.33% of 96? 33.33% of 96. What do we normally do? We'll use calculator, take 33.33 into 96 and then divide by 100. But the easiest way of doing this is, we know 33.33 is 1 by 3. So we can just take it as 1 by 3 into 96. 3 will go 32 times, so your answer will be 32. Similarly, if you have a question, 14.28% of 49. We can clearly see that 14.28% is nothing but 1 by 7. So it will be 1 by 7 into 49. 7 will go 7 times. So if you see, right, it helps you in saving a lot of time if you know the exact fraction for all these percentage values. So this is the base. From this we can develop and work out different types of questions. So if you look at another question, so what is 66.66% of 66? So 66.66, it is not given on that side of the board, it's not given at all. So how do we work it out? If you notice carefully, 33.33% is 1 by 3. 33.33% is 1 by 3. What is the connection between 33.33% and 66.66%? So if you look at the connection, this is nothing but into 2. So if you are multiplying the left side by 2, you need to multiply the right side also by 2. So this will be nothing but 2 by 3. So 66.66% is 2 by 3 into 66. 3 will go 22 times. 22 into 2 is 44. So this is again an application of the base. So we know 33.33% is 1 by 3. So 66.66% will be nothing but 2 times of that. 2 times of that is 2 by 3. So in this case, my answer is 44. We look at two more questions based on this. So we'll take one more. 28.56% of 63. Again, it is similar to this type of question. 14.28% is 1 by 7. 14.28% is 1 by 7. 14.28% is 1 by 7. So the relationship between 14.28% and 28.56 is nothing but 2 times, because 14.28 into 2 is 28.56. So this will be 2 by 7. So this will be 2 by 7 into 63. 7 will go 9 times. 9 into 2 is how much? 18. 9 into 2 is 18. Similarly, if we look at 44.44% of 36. 44.44% of 36. If you look at 44.44% of 36, 11.11% is nothing but 11.11% is nothing but 1 by 9. So if 11.11% is nothing but 1 by 9, if I multiply this by 4, I'll get 44.44%, which is nothing but 4 by 9. So this will be 4 by 9 into 36. 9 goes 4 times. 4 into 4 is 16. 4 into 4 is 16. So when it comes to formulas, right, the first formula that we look at is percent increase or decrease. Percent increase or decrease. So now consider I have 100 apples. I have 100 apples today. Tomorrow I have 150 apples. So today I have 100 apples, tomorrow I have 150 apples. If you look at it, right, the number of apples obviously increases by how much? It increases by 50. In terms of percentage, if you look at it, in terms of percentage, how much does it increase by? So in terms of numbers, it increases by 50. In terms of percentage also, it increases by 50%. It increases by how much? 50%. Because what is 50% of 100? 50% of 100 is nothing but 50. So, and if you look at it right, it is actually increasing by 50 apples. So this is increasing by 50%. 50% is nothing but 1 by 2. Now consider, tomorrow I am having 150. I am giving away 50 apples. That means how many apples am I having? I am having 100 apples. So I am giving away 50 apples. So obviously it's reducing. What is the percentage decrease in this case? Most of us will think, right, because from 100 it goes to 150, it is 50% increase. From 150, if it goes back to 100, it should be again 50% decrease. But if you look at it right, what is 50% of 150? 50% of 150 is, this is nothing but 1 by 2. 2 will go 75 times. So this will be, it reduces by 75. But in reality, is it actually reducing by 75 apples? No. It is reducing by 50 apples. So in this case, when it goes from 150 to 100, it is not reducing by 50%. So if you look at this carefully, the number of apples is reducing by 50. 50 on your initial quantity. What is your initial quantity? 150. So 50 on 150. What is 50 on 150? Nothing but 1 by 3. And what is 1 by 3? 1 by 3 we just now saw, right? 1 by 3 is nothing but 33.33%. So if for this particular question, it is actually reducing by 33.33%. 33.33% is 1 by 3. So it has increased by 50%, which is nothing but 1 by 2. It has reduced by 1 by 3, which is 33.33%. So if you look at this carefully, when it goes from A to B, that is, when it increases from A to B, this is an increase, and when it reduces from B and goes back to the original value A, it will reduce. So if you look at this, if it increases by 1 by n, it will reduce by 1 by n plus 1. Look at the same thing, you compare these two. In this case, this is your 100, this is your 150, and your n is nothing but 2. And in this case, it is 150. 150 goes to 100. So this will be, it will reduce by 1 by 2 plus 1, which is nothing but 1 by 3. So when you get such simple type of questions, without even applying any formula, just using common logic, you can easily finish off this particular question. Next. Now, how do you solve this using formula? How do you solve this using formula? If you want to solve this using formula, the basic formula is percentage increase or decrease is final value minus initial value by initial value into 100. So the formula is percentage increase or decrease is modulus of final value minus initial value by initial value into 100. So consider the same example which we saw. From 100 it goes to 150. This is my initial value. This is my final value. It is again increasing. So my percentage increase will be modulus of final minus initial. So 150 minus 100 by 100 into 100. So I will get 50 by 100 into 100. So this will go 2 times. So I will get, this will go 50 times. It's nothing but 50%. Similarly, the other way. From 150, it goes back to 100. It's obviously decreasing. So this will be percentage decrease, which will be, this is my initial, this is my final value. So it will be 100 minus 150 by 150 into 100. So you will get minus 50 because of the modulus. Because of the modulus, it will become plus 50. So it will be 50 by 150 into 100. 50 goes 3 times. What is 1 by 3? We already saw 1 by 3 is 33.33%. And without applying formula, when we have base values like this, where it goes from 100 to 150, and then again 150 to 100, if it increases by 1 by n, it should decrease by 1 by n plus 1. The first question that we look at is, the price of a TV has been increased by 33.33%. By what percent should the cost of the TV be reduced to get it back to its original price? This is very, very similar to the formula that we had just now seen, as well as the example that we had just now seen. Fine. So if you look at this, right, I'll assume, is anything given about the price of the TV? Nothing is given about the price of the TV. They've just said that the price of the TV has been increased by 33.33%. So what I'll do is, I'll assume that the cost of the TV is rupees 100. So now what happens to this? This has been increased by 33.33%. So from 100, they've increased it by 33.33%. What is 33.33%? 1 by 3. So from 100, it has been increased by 33.33% means, so obviously it is how much? 133.33. Now you look at the second part of the question. By what percent should the cost of the TV be reduced to get it back to its original price? So if you look at this, the cost now is 133.33. It is being reduced back to its original price. So the cost of the TV is now reduced to get back its original price. So what is the original price? 100 rupees. So from 133.33, it has been reduced back to its original price, which is 100. Now if you look at this and see carefully, this is very similar to our thing which I had given. From A, if it goes to B, and if it increases by 1 by n, from B, if it goes back to A, it will reduce by 1 by n plus 1. So in this case, it has increased by 1 by 3. So if you reduce it back, it will reduce back by 1 by 3 plus 1, which is nothing but 1 by 4. What is 1 by 4? 25%. So if you look at this question, the answer is, the cost of the TV has to be reduced back. In order to be reduced back to the original price, it should be reduced by 25%. Next one. If the cost of tea goes up by 20%, what should be the percentage reduction in the amount of tea consumed so that the total expenditure on tea remains the same? Here, this is very, very similar to the previous question. The only difference here is they are talking something about expenditure, but there's actually not much of a difference. So if you look at this, they are saying that the cost of tea goes up by 20%. Fine. So cost of tea goes up by 20%. So I'll assume that the cost of tea is rupees 100. So how much does it go up by? It goes up by 20%. So from 100, it increases by 20%. If it increases by 20%, 20% is nothing but 1 by 5. So if it increases by 20%, the new price is 120. So the cost of tea goes up by 20%. Then they're asking, what should be the percentage reduction in the amount of tea consumed so that the total expenditure on tea remains the same? See, in this question it's clearly given that they want to spend the same amount of money on tea. So in this particular case, if they want to spend the same amount of money on tea, in other words, the cost has to go down from 120 to 100. The cost has to go down from 120 on 100 so that the total expenditure on tea remains the same. In this particular question, we have to treat it such that the tea goes from 100 to 120. From 120, it has to go back to 100 so that we can maintain the same expenditure. So in this case, if it has to go back from 120 to 100, it is again very similar to from A, if it goes to B, and if it increases by 1 by n. From B, if it goes back to A, it will have to reduce. It will have to reduce by 1 by n plus 1. So in this case, it will be 1 by 5 plus 1. 1 by 5 plus 1 is 1 by 6. 1 by 6 is nothing but 16.67 percentage. So in this case, the percentage reduction in the amount of tea consumed will be 16.67%. So till now we have seen percent increase or decrease. Next important thing which we look at is when a number x is increased by y percent or when a number x is decreased by y percent. So consider I have again 100 apples. Tomorrow I am having 10% more, or in other words, my 100 apples has been increased by 10%. So this is my x, y is nothing but 10%. Y is 10%. So if you look at this, normally how do we solve this? We will have this 100 plus we will find out what is 10% of 100. So 10% of 100 will be 10 by 100 into 100. So this will be 100 plus this will cancel out, you will get 10, which is nothing but 110. So if I had 100 apples and tomorrow I'm having 10% more, I'm obviously having 110 apples. This is when I have x quantity and it is increased by y percent. Another example, I have 100 apples today, tomorrow I am having 10% less. So 10% less. So this is my x, which is 100, y is nothing but 10% less. Now how do you normally solve this? You are having your 100 and then tomorrow you are having 10% less of 100. So it will be 10 by 100 into 100, which is nothing but 100 minus 10, which is nothing but 90. So this will be 10% less of 100, which is 90. So this is how you normally do it logically. But when it comes with big numbers, it makes more sense to use a basic formula. So if you look at this, this 100 refers to your x. So it will be x plus and y is your 10%. So it will be x plus y by 100 into x. What is common to this particular equation? You have x common here, you have x common here. So you take x common out, it will be 1 plus y by 100. It will be x into 1 plus y by 100. Similarly, if you take this, x is again what? 100. So it will be x minus, what is your y? Y is 10%. So x minus y by 100 and this corresponds to x. So now what is common to both? X is common, so take out x, it will be 1 minus y by 100. So this case will be when it is 10, when it is y percent less, this will be when it is y percent more, when it is y percent more. So if you combine both and see, it is nothing but the formula will be x into 1 plus or minus y by 100, x into 1 plus or minus y by 100. So the formula is x into 1 plus or minus y by 100. So just in case somebody tells you he has 300 rupees and tomorrow he is having 40% more. So what you can do is you can just write it as 300 into 1 plus 40 by 100. So whenever it is more or increased, it will be plus. Whenever it is lesser or reduced, it will be minus. So you will get 300. This will be 140 by 100, 0, 0 will cancel out, 14 threes are 42, with the extra 0 you will get 420. So you will get 420. This formula will help you in saving time, and especially when it comes to bigger numbers like 3600, 5000, whatever, it will be much easier. So one more example, I have 400 and tomorrow I am having 30% less. So it will be 400, apply the formula, 400 into 1 minus. So when it is less, it will be 1 minus 30 by 100. So you will get 400 into 70 by 100. Cancel out, you will get 280. So this is 280 and this is 420. This will be applicable and this is very useful. This particular formula is very useful when it comes to profit and loss also. We'll just look at one question when it comes to profit and loss as to how we can apply this particular concept when it comes to profit and loss. So if you see, consider there's a shopkeeper. the cost of some item which he sells is maybe 600 rupees. So there's a particular shopkeeper, the cost of the item that he sells is 600 rupees. He makes a profit of 10% on selling the item. He makes a profit of 10% on selling the item. What is the selling price? What is the selling price? What is the selling price? Most of us are aware that profit percentage formula is profit by cost price into 100. Profit by cost price into 100, or in other words, profit is nothing but selling price minus cost price by cost price into 100. This is for profit percentage. Similarly, loss percentage will be, instead of profit, it will be loss. So it will be CP minus SP by CP into 100. So if you look at these two formulas, it's unnecessary. There are too many formulas. We can jumble up. We can move around the terms. We can move around the terms. And I can rewrite this equation as SP is equal to CP into 1 plus or minus profit or loss by 100. The same thing, only thing is I have moved around the terms. If it is profit, it will be plus. If it is loss, it will be minus. Compare this formula with this particular formula. It's nothing but this is your X. Your Y will be profit or loss percentage. So the same question, if you look at the same question, CP is 600, profit percentage is 10%. So your SP will be, in this case, this is 600 into 1 plus, because it is profit, it will be plus. 1 plus 10 by 100, you will get 600 into 110 by 100. 6 into 11 is 66, so you will get 660. The same can be applied when it is loss. If it is loss, it will be 1 minus. So based on the concept we just now saw, right, the formula will be X into 1 plus or minus Y by 100. X into 1 plus or minus Y by 100. So if it is increased by Y percent, you will put a plus. And if it's decreased by Y percent, you will put a minus. So we look at two questions based on this. First question, a number when increased by 42.84%, it becomes how much? 40. What is the number? So you have a number. When it is increased by 42.84%, it becomes 40, and they are asking you to find out that number. So I will take that number. So let the number be X. So let the number be X. So what happens? That number is increased by 42.84. Now what does this 42.84% correspond to? So now if we remember, 1 by 7 is 14.28%. We need to get 42.84%. And if you remember, what is 14 into 3? 14 into 3 is 42. Similarly, 28 into 3 is 84. So if I multiply this by 3, if I multiply 14.28 into 3, I'll get 42.84. If I multiply one side by 3, I need to multiply the other side by 3. So this will be 3 by 7. So in this case, your Y corresponds to how much? Your Y corresponds to 42.84%, which is nothing but, we just know, sir, right? Which is nothing but 3 by 7. So apply the formula. Here it's being increased. So it'll be X into 1 plus Y by 100. This becomes how much? 40. So X into 1 plus Y by 100, then the number becomes 40. So in this case, X into 1 plus, what is your Y? Your Y is 3 by 7. Your Y in terms of fractions is nothing but 3 by 7 is equal to 40. This will be X into, if you take LCM and you solve this, you will get 7 plus 3. 7 plus 3 is 10. 10 by 7 is equal to 40. 0 and 0 will cancel out. Then if you cross multiply, you will get X is equal to 28. So in other words, your number initially was 28. 28 was increased by 42.84%. And because it was increased by 42.84%, 28 became 40. So the cost of a car, the second question, the cost of a car depreciates by 15% every year. What is the value of the car after 2 years if the current cost is rupees 30,000? So the current cost is 30,000. It depreciates each year. Depreciates means it goes down each year by 15%. They're asking, what is the value of the car after 2 years? So now remember, depreciates two times. So because the initial cost, so your X is how much? Your X is 30,000. Your X is 30,000. Y is how much? 15%. And remember, this happens, they're asking the value of the car after 2 years. So now consider after the first year. After the first year, the value of the car will be X into 1 minus Y by 100. X into 1 minus Y by 100. Because here depreciating, it's reducing in value. So in this case, it will be 30,000 into 1 minus 15 by 100. So you will get 30,000 into 85 by 100. This is after the first year. Now, when you will get a particular value here. Now, we need to consider 2 years means after the second year. If you look at after the second year, this particular value, whatever value here, will again depreciate by 15%. So this value is there, right? 30,000 into 85 by 100 into 1 minus 15 by 100, you will get 30,000 into 85 by 100 into 85 by 100. So what you can understand from this is, instead of doing it step by step, year by year, you could have directly written it as X into 1 minus Y by 100 into 1 minus Y by 100. So instead of doing it year by year, I could have directly written it like this, where this will correspond to the first year, this would have corresponded to the second year. So I could have done it in directly in one step, where it would have been 30,000 into 1 minus 15 by 100 into 1 minus 15 by 100. So if you solve this, you will get 3 into 85 square is 7225. If you solve this, 756, you will get 21,675. So if you look at this, the value of the car, which was initially 30,000, after 2 years, after depreciating each year by 15%, is now currently at rupees 21,675. And as I had told, instead of going year after year, that is after the first year, it depreciates once by 15%. And then after the second year, it depreciates again by 15%. Instead, you can directly combine and take it as X into 1 minus Y by 100 into 1 minus Y by 100. You will get the same answer. So consider, if the car had depreciated and they're asking you what is the value of the car after 3 years, what would you do is you would just have to put one more 1 minus Y by 100. The third one. So till now we have seen, first one was percentage increase or decrease. The second one was X is increased by Y percent or X is decreased by Y percent. So the third one we're going to see is, it's an important thing actually. A is what percentage of B? It can be given like this, or what percentage of B is A? So A is what percentage of B, or A is what percentage of B, or what percentage of B is A? We look at a basic question. 52 is what percentage of 520? 52 is what percentage of 520? So if you look at it like this, forget this part. So now what is 10% of 520? What is 10% of 520? 10% of 520 will be 10 by 100 into 520. So how much will you get? You will get 52. In other words, 52 is nothing but 10% of 520. So how do you solve this? So how do you solve this? The formula for both of these cases is nothing but A by B into 100. It's nothing but A by B into 100. This will correspond to your A. This will correspond to your B. So you will get 52 by 520 into 100. 52 will go 10 times. And what is 1 by 10? It is nothing but 10%. 1 by 10 is nothing but 10%. So consider, you have a city. You have a city, and the number of cars manufactured, number of cars manufactured in that particular city is 1,000. Number of cars manufactured in that city is 1,000, and there is a seller A. There's a seller A. Actually, we'll take it as there's a manufacturer A. There's a manufacturer A who manufactures 100 cars. So my question is, what is the market share of A? What is the market share of A? What is the market share of A? So in this particular city, the number of cars manufactured is 1,000. Manufacturer A manufactures 100 cars. So the question is, what is the market share of A? You can rephrase this question to, 100 is what percentage of 1,000? Or in other words, the number of cars manufactured by A is what percentage of the total number of cars manufactured in that particular city. So again, this is your A, this is your B. Apply this particular formula, you will get 100 by 1,000 into 100. You cancel out, you will get correctly 10%. So more or less, for most of the market share questions, we'll have to apply this particular question. So, and in most of the cases, they will not give it as 52 is what percent of 520. They'll ask it as what percent of 520 is 52. So we should not place this as A and this as B. We should take it just like this. What percentage of B is A? Same formula. So it will be 52 by 520 into 100. 52 goes 10 times, you will get 10%. So based on this particular concept, the first question that we are going to see is, if X is 80% of Y, what percent of X is Y? So X is 80% of Y. They have not given any values for X and Y. They just stated that X is 80% of Y. So in this particular case, so if you look at it, X is 80% of Y. That is 80 by 100 of Y. So X is 80% of Y. It makes a lot of sense to assume Y to be 100. So if I assume Y to be 100, X will be 80 by 100 into 100. You will get 80. So X is how much? 80. Now we'll go to the question. So actually it doesn't make any difference. If you take X to be 100 also, you will get Y to be a different answer. In this particular case, it'll be easy both the ways. If you take Y to be 100 or X to be 100. So what is my question? What percentage of X is Y? What percentage of X is Y? In other words, what is your X? X is 80. So what percentage of 80 is 100? Because Y is how much? Y is 100. This is similar to this. What percentage of B is A? So A is your 100, B is your 80. Apply the formula A by B into 100. You will get 100 by 80 into 100. 20 goes 4 times, 20 goes 5 times. So you will get 5 by 4 into 100. Then 4 goes 25 times. 25 into 5 is 125%. So in other words, what percent of 80 is 100 is nothing but 125%. A fruit vendor has 40 fruits on his cart, 30% of which are apples. If the fruit vendor receives a new shipment of 80 fruits, 40% of which are not apples, what percent of the total number of fruits are apples? So initially, you have a fruit vendor who has 40 fruits on his cart. So initially the number of fruits is 40. Out of this 40, 30% of it are apples. So now what is 30%? 30% of 40, 30 by 100 into 40, you will get 12. So out of these 40 fruits, apples is how much? Apples is 12. Next. The fruit vendor now receives a new shipment of 80 fruits. So the new shipment of fruits has how many fruits? Has totally 80 fruits. Out of which it's clearly given that 40% are not apples. Now you see, 40% are not apples. Obviously 60% have to be apples. So 60% of this, so 40% are not apples means 60% are apples means 60% of this. So it'll be 60 by 100 into 80. So 60% of this is nothing but 48. So out of these 80 fruits, apples are nothing but 48. Now if you look at these two, what is the total number of fruits? Total fruits is equal to 40 plus 80. 40 plus 80 is nothing but 120. And how many apples are there totally? The total number of apples is 12 and 48. So 12 plus 48 is 60. So the total number of fruits is 120. The total number of apples is 60. We'll now look at the question. What percentage of the total number of fruits are apples? So what percentage of the total number of fruits? Total fruits are apples. Total fruits are apples. So now how many fruits are there? You have totally 120 fruits. So what percentage of 120 are 60? Because apples is how much? Apples is 60. This is nothing but what percentage of B is A. So you will get 60 by 120. Same formula. A by B into 100. So you will get 60 by 120 into 100. 60 goes 2 times. 1 by 2 into 100 is 50%. So the thing was, what percentage of total fruits are apples? The total number of fruits is 120. Apples is 60. So what percentage of 120 is 60? You will get 60 by 120 into 100, which is 50%. So the next one we are going to see is quite lengthy actually. So the thing is, A scored 25% of the marks in an exam and failed by 20 marks. So A scores 25% of the marks in an exam and he fails by 20 marks. B scored 40% of the marks in the same exam and he scored 4 marks more than the pass mark. So A fails by 20 marks, B scores 4 marks more than the pass mark. What percent of the total marks is the pass mark? Now consider in an exam, the maximum mark is 100. The maximum mark in an exam is 100. You get 40%. So a student gets 40%. So the maximum mark is 100. A student gets 40%. So how much does he get? He gets 40% means 40 by 100 into 100, which will be nothing but 40 marks. Similarly, I am giving you one more statement. He gets 10 marks more than the pass mark. So if you look at it, he's actually getting 40. As well as he gets 10 marks more than the pass mark means, pass mark is, we'll take it as P. P plus 10 is how much he gets? 40. So obviously the pass mark is how much? P will be 40 minus 10, which is 30. So in the example that I'm giving here, the maximum mark is 100. The student gets 40% of the maximum mark, which is nothing but 40 marks. As well as I'm giving one more statement which states that he gets 10 marks more than the pass mark means he is getting 40. Obviously, the pass mark has to be 30. So if you look at this carefully, this is nothing but your pass mark plus the 10 marks more that he gets than the pass mark is equal to 40% of the maximum marks. 40% of the maximum. Same thing, because 40% of 100 is 40. You're equating this with the 10 marks more than the pass mark. The same concept we can apply here. So if you look at A, but before that, I'll assume that the maximum mark is X, as well as the pass mark, I'll take it to be P. So if you look at A, A scored 25% of the marks in an exam. So 25% of the maximum marks. So it will be 25 by 100 into X. And this is equal to, and it's clearly given that he has failed by 20 marks. What is the pass mark again? P. He fails by 20 marks means he's getting 20 marks less than the pass mark. See, in this particular example which I had given, he got 10 marks more than the pass mark. In this case, he's getting 20 marks less than the pass mark. So it will be pass mark minus 20. This is for A. Now when you look at B, B has scored 40% of the marks in an exam. So when you take B, B has scored 40% of the total marks. And he has also scored 4 marks more than the pass mark. So 4 marks more than the pass mark will be P plus 4. So 4 marks more than the pass mark will be P plus 4. Now we need to solve both of these equations. If you look at P, P is 25x by 100. Take the 20 to the left side. This is 1. This is equation number 2. Then you substitute the value for P in equation number 2. So substitute 1 in 2. So you will get 40x by 100. P is how much? P is 25x by 100 plus 20. 25x by 100 plus 20. Remember, there's a 4 here also, plus 4. Take it to the left side, you will get 15x by 100. How did I get 15x by 100? I subtracted 40x by 100 minus 25x by 100. This is equal to 24. Then X is equal to, take 100 to the left, to the right side, 100 into 24 by 15, 3 goes 5 times, 3 goes 8 times, 5 goes 20 times. So your maximum mark is 160. What is your maximum mark? Your maximum mark is 160. The next important thing is, I have to find out my pass mark. So if you look at the pass mark, just substitute the value for X. X is equal to 160 in equation 1. Substitute X is equal to 160 in equation 1. So you substitute X is equal to 160 in equation 1, you will get P is equal to 25 into 160 by 100 plus 20. So 25 goes 4 times, 4 goes 40 times, so 40 plus 20 is 60. So what is your pass mark? Your pass mark is 60, your maximum mark is 160. Now we'll go back to the question. What are they asking in the question? What percent of the total marks is the pass mark? So what percent of the total marks? So what is your total marks here? X is your pass mark, which is P. So what percent of X is P? In other words, what percent of 160 is 60. So this will be your B, this will be your A. Again, apply the formula A by B into 100. So you'll get 60 by 160 into 100. If you solve this, you will get 37.5%. So 2 will go, so 4 will go 15 times, 4 will go 4 times, 2 will go 2 times, 2 will go 5 times. You will get 75 by 2. 75 by 2 is 37.5%. So in this particular case, what is the percentage of the total marks? Is the pass mark? It's nothing but 37.5%.